Hi, how are you? Look what I found. These are the blackbirds I was telling you about. Look how large they are. These are very aggressive blackbirds or ravens. They look like crows, and they are just brutally territorial. And I just pulled up to this the next viewing site, and you can just get an idea of how large these birds are. Still sitting in the vehicle, and I hope when I get out of the vehicle, perhaps he'll fly away. This is where I am now, and this is the crow. These are these beautiful birds that just soar in the wind of the Grand Canyon and just glide and go up and down, and especially when it's mating season. This is Moran Point, and I better keep it on that one. Look at this. Can you believe how lucky I get to see all this wildlife? Now he's gonna fly away. I'm gonna get as close as I can before he does, so you can actually see the size of this bird. Look at the size of this bird. Much larger than a crow's at home. God. He's just watching. He doesn't want to go anywhere.
So, like, where do you live? When would you consider spring?
So, this is, let me go over here and see what's on the board over here. Very nice. Is that a big bird or what? Look at the beak on that bird. That bird will go after vultures, hawks, ravens, smaller birds, you name it. And look like he's just interested in watching me right now. Look at the size of this bird. Look at the size. Look how big they are. We are very lucky that we actually got one that we can get this close to. You know, maybe he wants me to come up and pet him.
Yeah, they can be friendly sometimes. I'm not taking that chance.
No, look at the beak on that one.
I know, that would do some damage. No doubt about that.
All right, this bird is eating up time. All right, I'm going to come around and see what's going on over here. Keep an eye on the bird while I look at this thing here. Near here in the late summer of 1540, soldiers from the Spanish expedition of Francisco Vendel Coronado Vesquez de Coronado became the first Europeans to see the Grand Canyon. After journeying for 6 months, Coronado's army arrived at the Hopi Mesa east of the Grand Canyon. From there, Grisha Lopez de Garces, guided by Hopi Indians, led a small party of men to find a reported great river. After 20 days, they reached the south rim of the Grand Canyon, emerging from the forest to stand on the edge of this vast, vast canyon. Spanish discovery. All right. Yeah, the Spanish were everywhere but in Spain at one time. They just love getting on those boats and just going. And this bird, maybe the bird has got its legs stapled to the branch. It just doesn't want to go. Well, I'll leave it alone then. Maybe he thinks I'm a bird. All right, let's go and see what this one is about. Bye-bye. Massive bird. Massive. Look how big he is. I don't know if you can find it. You should be able to tell how big it is. All right, let's go over here and see this viewing point. This is Moran Viewing Point. Moran. Maybe there'll be a placard. This is number 5. And This is number 5, and this is breathtaking, as usual, as they all are. And on this one, you can actually see the snaking of the Colorado River. See? I don't know if you can see this from this vantage point, but you can see the Colorado River snaking through the canyon. Thought I'd get that close to one of those
the dam upstream. It's catching all the silt that made the river red, and it's stuck behind the dam, and now they can't figure out what to do.
So what do you have? You have trout?
Trout. Used
bass.
To
no bass?
No bass. We used to have crappies, but now we have trout. Because the native fish can't live in the cold.
Trout are delicious.
What are the three dams besides the Hoover and the other two?
The Glen Canyon, and the third one is way up, and I don't know the
right
name of it.
But there's, I think someone said there were just three major dams on the Colorado.
Yeah, the Grand Canyon goes from the Glen Canyon Dam to the Hoover Dam.
Wow.
277 river miles. That's not straight on a map miles, that's river miles.
Wow, thank you so much.
Sure.
Well, that was nice. She was a tour guide, I guess, for a private party. Okay, this is a Canyon on Canvas. Artist Thomas Moran, M-O-R-A-N, was a storehouse of pictures. In 1873, geologist John Wesley Powell invited Moran to accompany his geologic survey of the Grand Canyon region. For Moran, the canyon was by far the most awfully grand and impressive scene. As a premier painter of American landscapes, Moran helped inspire Western tourism and pushed Congress toward the establishment of the Western National Parks in an area of black and white photographs and etchings. Moran's vibrantly colored paintings brought Grand Canyon to life for a nation. Wow, isn't that nice? So there he is right there.
Yeah, okay. See that big flat area there?
Uh-huh.
I see weddings out there. Ooh, at least once a month. You can go down a little trail and get to that big flat spot.
The river that goes by my house into the bay and then into the ocean. They have a park in my town in the center of the village, and they have waterfalls.
Oh,
but like, you know, little controlled waterfalls.
Yeah.
Every Dominican in New York, and I don't know why it's Dominicans, every Dominican in New York City goes takes their wedding photos.
Oh.
I guess it went, and they have nothing to do with our village.
Right, but they come and...
I'm from Long Island.
Hey, you're from Long Island.
Babylon, right?
All right. So the weddings will take place on the first rock or the second one?
That big flat area.
Right here?
Yeah.
They're taking a chance, huh?
Well, there's a trail.
Wow.
Yeah, the best clothing I ever saw was the bridesmaids. They had the formal floor-length dresses, but they had Converse high-top shoes dyed to match their dresses.
That's where they have weddings, they said, right over there in that area. The weddings.
You see the rapid down there? That's Gans Rapid. You see the Pants Rapid. That's the one where Powell lost his boat, right down there. That's over a mile long, and the river is moving at about 35 miles an hour. It's 52 degrees Fahrenheit. My advice is to stay in the boat. Now you can see that in that white water. It looks like that it's just standing in one spot, isn't it?
You see a little bit of sea movement.
Yeah, but not at 35 miles an hour.
Right. That's for sure.
But here, so you got this wave that's kind of just standing there, and the water goes through the wave. But when you go to the beach, the wave goes through the water, doesn't it? Wow, I love this planet. Just mixes it up for us all the time, you know? Keeps it different.
So which way did the people who abandoned the boat go? That way or this
yeah,
way?
They went up the North Rim. But they didn't abandon it here. They went down a little further.
Oh, okay.
Then they finally gave up when they realized that we don't want to do this anymore. Like I said, there's over 100 rapids. Pants Rapid down there is a class 5, and it's one of the bad ones. But there's still 100 rapids to be done. And some of them, they had to be portaged, you know? They had to take their boats out and carry them on their shoulders. And that's no fun. That's a lot of work.
Teddy Roosevelt, there's a book about him in the Amazon called The River of Doubt, I think it's called. And it talks about that, how they had to take their boats out of the river and what do you call that when they do that?
Portage.
Portage.
Pretty cool. You guys want a picture together?
Yeah, sure.
That's one of the reasons I'm here. Just ask. It's okay.
Yeah, can you do it?
Yeah. That's why I'm here.
Yeah, I just remembered the name of that book. If you like to read books, I think it's called River of Doubt. I may be mistaken, but I believe it's River of Doubt. And if you like to read books, this is a book you won't be able to be put down. And it's the story of Teddy Roosevelt and his expedition down the Amazon. And at that time, a lot of the Amazon wasn't even discovered or mapped. And that's what Teddy Roosevelt and his expedition were trying to do. They were trying to map portions of the Amazon. And he almost nearly lost his life doing it. So I got to take a look at this Grand Canyon. This might be, this is number 5 in a series. Starting at the desert view. This might be my last view of the Grand Canyon if I head towards Williams and back to the West Coast.
Let me show you guys something, then I'll kick you off for a minute or two. Gentlemen, you're welcome. Something I want to show the ladies. A couple of things real quick. This is called Mormon tea. And as the stories go, when the Mormons were out here looking for places to settle, somebody made a tea from this. I really liked it. But Mormons have rules about what they can ingest, right? So they had to get permission from the elder with them. And he loved it. And so everybody got it. Mormon tea. Now I'll tell you the real name. Ephedra.
Oh, wait a second.
Oh.
Thanks for the peanut gallery out there. Yeah. That's why they like it. It's a stimulant, right? It works on your allergies and your colds. It works real good. This is what I really want to
say. Do you need an ID to buy that plant, though?
It's dead, obviously. That's natural state. It's actually a spore carried by birds. When it gets into a host, it will kill it. And right now it's in the junipers. It has already got this one. You can see it's killing this one right here. See the clumps sticking out? It's trying to mimic its host so that birds will land on it and carry those spores to the next host. It's pretty insidious. It's called mistletoe. You might be familiar with mistletoe from like Christmas time. It comes from a holly plant though. So it's mimicking the holly. Whereas here, can you make me with juniper? So I tell you this to my ladies, because look, you're going to be at a Christmas party, right? And some guy's going to say, hey, baby, come here, give me a kiss. And you can say, no, that's a parasite, so are you. You guys want to take 5 or 10, and I'll see you back at the van, okay?
Very interesting. Very interesting. And those are the rapids, the Hans. The Hans rapids again. See? Those are the Hans rapids that the gentleman was talking about. Okay, I'm gonna shut this video. This is well over 10 minutes, but I didn't wanna shut it. It has some pretty useful information by the guide, and I didn't wanna cut the video while he was talking about some interesting things. Everywhere you look is a breathtaking view. It just doesn't stop. It's just, it's overwhelming. And there's the snaking of the Colorado River in the background. Okay, I'm gonna shut it off now. I'm having a hard trouble shutting it off. This is 16 minutes now. Sorry, folks.